All right, so now we're going to hit up what's called a stick crunch. So a stick crunch, you can use a chair or a box if you need to, or if you're at home, you can pull out a drawer a little bit, and you want it to be about 18 inches off the ground, up or down a couple inches, you'll still be able to get a good effect. So what I'll do is I'm going to lay with my feet flat on the wall if I can. If you're on a box and you can't do feet on something and you're just going to dig down, then hey, do the best you can, right? But I'm gonna put the ball between my knees. My knees are at 90 degrees. My hips should be at about 90 degrees. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna breathe in and I am going to exhale and I'm gonna be pushing into the wall, but I'm gonna dig down with my heels and my tailbone's gonna come 1 inch off the ground. You should feel your hamstrings picking you up. Don't think about raising your hips. So it's breath in, exhale, drive down, tailbone comes. Your abs here should be relaxed and you're tall. You're gonna grab the stick right here, breathe in, and now you'll reach your body up. I should have had my head on the ground while I was doing that. And so you have to keep your hamstrings on while you reach. And as you exhale, you're trying to exhale these ribs down. So it's breath in. Try and keep your six-pack abs relaxed and feel your obliques and your ribs come down as you get a full exhalation. The more air out you get, the absolute better on this one. So that is your stick crunch.